Game on. Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Ardent, rule the water.
Now that's why they call me the extreme.
Strike King Lure Company, gearing up champions for over 40 years. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
Here he comes. Here he comes. Oh, it is a good one too. See that?
But when it gets tough, I found a bait that I really like catching them on, and I believe it really makes a difference.
We'll be right back.
It looks nice. It's real nice. Killer. Hey folks, welcome back to another Extreme Angler TV. You know what? This week I'm going to fish the way I love to fish for smallmouth bass on top. But sometimes they can be sluggish on top. And what I mean is they're still going to come up. You're still going to get some fish that blast it. The majority I found lately have been coming up, looking. If your bait's moving, they just slowly go back down. What I'm going to do today is slow it down. Dead stick. Make it look like it's dying. The different variety of baits. My little Sub-Zero crankbait, my walking bait, and the popper. Same baits that I use when I'm fishing quite aggressively for these really active smallmouth, but different cadence. Dead slow, make it look like it's dying or dead. Let them come up, they're opportunistic. Smallmouth see that, they'll give it a shot. Let's see what happens. Hopefully it does. One of my first options is a little waking bait. It's actually a little striking pro model crankbait, but it's got a real shallow lip. It's made for real shallow water. What I'm fishing is the deeper stuff, 5 feet, 8, 10, even casting out to the 30 foot edges and stuff. But what I'm doing is trying to provoke a strike, casting it out, you know, letting it sit, and then just tight wobble, coming up to the surface. Looks like something's dying on its last breath, and just working it slow, having faith in the bait in the region I'm fishing, believing that there is fish in that region, and working it slow, and it's a great bait when the fish aren't totally suicidal on top or super aggressive. They still want to eat on top, but they want something that looks like it's dying. So this little bait, you can cast it out, put it out in the right spots, it sits there, I wait for the rings to subside, a little shot, just in case the fish is coming up from 8-10 feet of water to look at it. It darts side to side, down, and it comes up. They see that. That little action, it provokes bites. Trust me. You work it, it's something they haven't seen. A lot of guys are throwing topwater and poppers and jerk baits and walking baits, you name it. They're going steady, steady, want those fish to chase it and stuff. The way I use it to provoke those strikes from fish that see other stuff go by, this stops, they look, it's still there, they come up and they eat it. Oh, he bumped it. Look at that. Wow. See? It's weird. They're hitting it like... Thunk. He actually bumped it. Look. Go on. Got him. See? Not a real big fish. But boy, are they slow. Slow, slow, slow. They're just taking their time to eat these baits this morning. Look at them. Look at them go. Pretty cool, man. You can entice them with that dead stick approach. Beautiful rods. You gonna spit it? You want to come in the boat? Here, catching them like KVD on a crank, except I ain't ripping it like KVD. I'm slowly roll. Whoa, slow rolling it. It's a nice sharp hook, so striking bait's got it. Eh? There he goes. Have to slow it down, slow it down. Smaller one, unfortunately, ate it. Throw it, you wait. That waiting game, if you do it, you're gonna catch the fish that other guys miss because they went into that area too quick. You slow down, little baits, like the shallow running crankbait, and slow your retrieve right down, stays in their strike zone, they gotta eat it. Let's keep going. Throwing it like KVD. And cover lots of water too, it's great. Cover water, but slowly just work it slow. Little sweeps with the rod like this. Reel not slack line, twitch it, bring it down, just sweep it. Got that long 7.2 medium power crankbait rod. St. Croix Legend Extreme. 10 pound test, the Ardent, make long casts, cover water, find those fish. They're not aggressive, but I'm finding them. It's a search bait. When they see it, every time they've got to take at least one little effort to come up and they show you they're there. That's all that's got to happen. You can go back with a secondary bait and catch those fish. You got to entice them. When you don't want to eat, you make them eat. Got to trick them. See what I mean? Crazy, eh? Crazy. Crazy on the crank. Look. Just a nice little fish. Chunkers. But fooling them. That's right. You thought you had an easy meal, didn't you? A minnow. Perch. Something on the surface. Something looked like it was dying. Something looked like it was dying. He took advantage of it. That's it. Get rid of that energy, huh? You about done? Come on, get it out of your system and just bring them in. You don't have to even touch them. Look at that, barely in the nose. Look at that, eh? And just turn it. He's back safely. A little crankbait, but I want to show you something. The little cross lock snap there. So that bait just goes ta-ta-ta-doom, ta-ta-ta-doom. There's various knots you can tie to make a loop knot, etc. But you never want to tie it exactly right to the nose or the little split ring. You want the most action from your bait, even when you're doing it really subtle. A little tight wobble and little stop comes up and bobs. Fish see that, they eat it. I go and I stop. I go and I stop. Back and forth. I think I made a little bit of noise. So in that case, the old Spitting King is a great another backup bait that you can pop, 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 fizz, stop, let them see it, eat it, make a little noise.
Make some noise!
Individual fish are great on top. The chances are there could be a big roamer, but if you want action and excitement, find the pack of wolves. Two fish, four, five, 10, whatever it is, find the pack. Depending on what you want to do. You want to catch those single big ones, put in the time and effort. You want to catch a bunch, move around a bit and find the little pack. Sometimes they're not as big, but it's action. All depending on what you want. Yep, see? While it's sitting there, eh? While it's sitting there, boy, oh boy. They are so predictable sometimes, aren't they? Let's back off a little bit. See, they're not that crazy. They're jumping around, but it's like a lazy jump. Look at it. It's a lazy jump. You done? I'm out for fun here. So if they pop off, I'm all right with it. Hold on, hold on. There he goes. See? Just a decent little fish. A fun fish. Fun to catch. Ready? Go back. Tell your friends to come and eat. We'll see you again. Bait just sitting there, not doing anything. Get his attention, leave it. Looks like it's dying, he eats it. Let's keep going. Now another option is, You've seen how extreme angler me throwing the topwaters a lot. Little poppers, the spitting king, the walking baits. The walking bait, it's a great alternative bait when you're looking for those fish that are not aggressive. It's a do-nothing bait. You can keep going, and the fish are aggressive, make them chase it. But today, I use it the same way I do that little crankbait. I put it out, it lands, and I wait. Just like the old school, wait till the ripples subside. Then I get a little shot, see what pops? Side to side, it just pops. And I'm waiting. And let it sit. How's that for a strike, hey? Told ya. You throw it on top and they're gonna eat it. They eat it nice. Eat just a small one, but make it look dead and they're gonna eat it. Anybody else home? Yep, you see that? And it's a good one too. Oh boy. Oh, he's gonna come up, ready? Here he comes. Oh, it is a good one too. See that? Just gonna play him out. Use your rod and your body. A little bit of drag set, just in case he makes those big power runs. I think he's somewhat hooked. Oh boy. Look at that. Popped off, and look where he ended up. That's why those lucky strike catch and release nets, you got to have them. If you don't, those fish will be released even before they're caught. Not big, but man, oh man, tough, eh? Oh, it is a good one too. You're a bully, are you? Let's see, bully. We'll put you back, ready? Now I can see the way they're fighting, okay? Gives you an indication. Most times you see on our show when we hit those fish on top water, they're out of the water more than they're in the water, but they're not. They're making the initial, and then just like a lazy action, bulldogging, you know, using all their power to pull down and stuff. It shows you they're not real aggressive. You slow down, make your bait look like it's dying, they'll eat it. Come on up. And those fish today, I've been looking at it, coming up, and I can see, even from a distance without Polaroid glasses, I can see them coming up and looking. And as soon as I get a little shot, it bobs like that. They see the tail feathers just open up, a little bit of glitter, whoop, they suck it down, or they roll on it, got them. So there's two different ways you can throw it. Aggressively, or with the do-nothing approach. Let it sit, pop it, let it go, pop it again. And you can see how it looks in the water. It looks amazing, man. Fish see that, they gotta eat it. It's a great alternative when the fish are slow, but they still wanna eat. I know they're in here some. Oh my God, you got it. Oh yeah, see? If you let it sit, what did I say, huh? You let it sit and they'll go cycle for it. Wow. Like a bomb. Like a bomb went off, eh? Not even a giant bass, but the way he ate it, it was like a bomb went off. Kapoom. And I tell you, man, it is just phenomenal when you can get them to eat it like that. See, move around a little bit. Other spots, got in the nose too. You see what I mean? You move around, but the key has been looks like it's gonna be today. Let it sit. Let it sit. Let them look at it. They explode on it, but they don't eat it. Looks like they're trying to bash it. Make sure it's dead. Oh my God. But just seeing that, when you're going along thinking, oh, maybe not, they wake you up. Here, look at this. Pads. It sits. You twitch it. Let the fish find it. All of a sudden, it's kapoof. There's no way you even know there's a fish even there. It's about trust, focus, concentration, and believing you're in the right spots. Look at that swirl behind there. Oh my God. Got him. Look at this one. Oh yeah. See how slow? See how slow? You see how slow? Incredible, eh? See how long I had to wait for that fish to come up? And I think he's a big one too. Oh yeah, he's a real good one. You gotta wait and wait and wait. Let it sit there, and then they find it. It's incredible, man. Oh, that's a real nice one too. Look at them. But boy, do they want it slow. Just dead stick, and there he is. That's what I was talking about. That's what I was coming for. Well, that's an indication right there. Look at this. He barely had that in his nose. But that's what I came for, right there. You know what? Missed a few, caught a few. But when you get them like that, it's all well worth the effort of dead sticking top waters on top. I'm gonna put them in there for a picture and stick around for a little bit more. The sun's gone away, temperatures have dropped. I don't know if that has something to do with it, but they've just decided that they want it dead slow. You slow it down, you can catch them too. Let's put them in there for a few pictures. There's so many different tools to use to catch bass, smallmouth and largemouth. But topwater, it's one of the most exciting ways to catch them. And you know what? I'll stick it out because soon it's going to be fall and they just slow right down. And you know what? You might get a few days that are exceptional with it on top and stuff. But for the majority, you got to go vertically or twitch baits and different things. But the topwater bite is one of the ways that I grew up fishing bass, and I know you probably did too. It's exciting seeing them blow up, the swirl. But sometimes, like today, they want it dead stuck. Right down, look at it, then they eat it. Oh, a few more, then I'm out of here. Oof. Like, I mean, put it out, let it sit. Don't move it, let it sit there. I guarantee those fish know it's there. The little shot, see how it looks? Looks like something's hurt, dying. Let it sit again. It bobs back and forth, whether it be a crankbait, the popper, just small twitches. And what's imperative is you have to keep your eyes on the bait. Because a lot of times you're looking for those subsurface bites, the fish just swirl. And after they move, you see the water move, like a toilet flush, they call it. That's the key to this dead sticking technique with the topwater. Fishing it slow, methodically, but then you catch those bigger fish. When other guys aren't, or when they think that the topwater bite is off. It's never totally off. You just gotta adjust your presentation, speed, cadence, and give the fish exactly what they want each day. You'll catch more. Got him. Good one too. Yeah, look at that, eh? You let it sit for a second. You just let it sit. What do? Well, they find it. That's just another chunk, you know that? Just another fun fish. But he ate it the right way. When it's sitting on top, and it's just sitting doing, oh! And he bounced off. Well, is that a good way to end it? That's the way it goes. You know what? But so what? But it goes to show you that sometimes throwing top waters, you just can't go and expect it's always gonna be the same way, because it's not. You slow it down sometimes, dead stick it on the surface, let it sit there, they'll find it, they'll eat it. So add that to your arsenal, put it in your toolbox of presentations, baits, and you will catch way more fish, even on top, when they don't want to bite. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV. Get hooked, stay hooked, because every day is a good day for fishing.
Snagproof, the world's finest weedless lures. Fishoflage, for love of the sport. Daiichi, bleeding red hooks. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.